Limited water resources in many regions make it necessary to reuse water that has undergone adequate treatment. This helps to preserve natural water resources and to also protect the environment. Among the available treatment technologies to regenerate wastewater are those that use membranes. Membranes are used because of their ability to retain solids and salts and to even disinfect water, which can then be reused for irrigation and other applications. A membrane is a material that allows certain substances to pass through while blocking others. In the case of water purification or reclamation, the water flows across the membrane, which blocks undesirable species. By choosing the right type of membrane and making use of it appropriately, almost any contaminant can be trapped. When membrane bioreactors are applied to wastewater treatment, they are generally used to replace the traditional activated sludge process currently used in most water purification plants. For the activated sludge to work, the production of aerobic microorganisms requiring oxygen is encouraged. This process involves large reactors that cause organic matter to decompose. The water containing these microorganisms is then poured off into what we call a secondary clarifier, leaving a clear supernatant of purified water, which can then be discharged or put through for further treatment to improve its quality or subsequent reuse. In the membrane bioreactor, this secondary clarifier is replaced by a filtration through membranes that traps microorganisms and other species and produces high-quality water ready for use. The main limitation of membrane bioreactors, as with other membrane technologies, is the high operational costs resulting from energy consumption. Almost 75% of electricity costs in this type of bioreactor are generated in getting the aeration required to initiate the biological process and, to a lesser extent, in making the water bubbles so as to produce turbulence near the membrane. This turbulent flow of water is used to help to control build-up of species on the membrane, or membrane fouling, which gradually reduces the membrane's efficiency as a filter. Research carried out by our team has contributed to improving understanding of the mechanisms that gradually pollute membranes and which reduce their medium or long-term usefulness. By working with the variables in the process, the ways of functioning, etc., it's been possible to produce water that can be used for crops, parks, and the irrigation of gardens. It's also been possible to improve the recovery of nutrients in water, particularly nitrogen, which is, in its nitrate form, easily absorbed by plants. When we started working in this area, our main aim was to improve knowledge of the phenomena involved in membrane fouling, in order to prevent or reduce it, to ensure long-term sustainability. We firmly believe that the results currently achieved benefit society in general through correct water resource management at the local level. They also benefit the agricultural, industrial and hotel sectors by making quality reclaimed water available and by promoting reuse of water resources. Without this reuse, water resources would be dumped into the sea or to the soil, thus producing the continued overexploitation of groundwater and energy resources used to pump and to desalinate sea or brackish water. This research works on the assumption that wastewater treatment, be it domestic, tourist, or industrial wastewater, is today a statutory obligation. Regeneration is only the first step towards purification that can be successfully achieved through technologies such as membrane bioreactors. If in addition to the reuse of water, nutrients in the water can be recovered, spending on fertilizers can be reduced and the environmental impact limited. The research has been carried out both in laboratories and in semi-industrial scale units with real water mainly household water, in order to verify the results. This research would not have been possible without the collaboration or the support from businesses in the sector, from the public administration, and from institutions. This collaboration has been crucial for the development of our studies. Our team is currently working on transferring part of the methodology used in aerobic bioreactors to membrane bioreactors operating in anaerobic conditions, in other words, without oxygen. In these anaerobic membrane bioreactors, water purification is produced by means of anaerobic microorganisms in a much more sustainable system, which saves energy because air bubbling is not needed, and a burnable gas consisting primarily of methane is produced, which can then be a source of energy during the process.